So a lot of people have been asking me how exactly I get so much steel. So that's why I want to make a little video about it and explain how exactly you get the most steel and how you preserve that steel, because a thing that a lot of people forget about it is that it doesn't only matter how much steel you're getting, but how you're spending it. So I will start with explaining how exactly you can earn steel. There are the very obvious things like doing your dailies and doing your contract orders. A lot of people don't do their contract orders regularly, which is stupid because if you do your stuff, you do all of this every 2 days and the dailies every day, you get about 2,500 steel every 2 days, every other day. So it's pretty good. That's quite a lot. Then, obviously, if there are event orders, you should do them. Or you only have to participate, you only have to do one match, for example. If there's an event order in elimination, you should play one match of elimination, even if you highly dislike that mode. Just bear through it. And if there's, for example, an order where it says, 24 takedowns as a Vanguard, then, and you don't like playing as a Vanguard, well, just do it. It's not a lot of time you will need for this, and it will give you a little bit of bonus steal. For example, I don't like playing as assassins that much, but I still do those assassin contracts because I need the steal, but I want the steal. The less obvious ways are obviously doing the trials, the Apprentice Trial and the Warrior Trials. I think the Apprentice Trial gives you 2,000 steel and the Warrior Trial 1,500. I could be wrong here. I know that the tutorial in the earlier version of the game gave you 2,100 and 1,500 for the basic and advanced tutorials. I think those two give you the same amount, but I might be wrong there. So if I'm wrong there, correct me please. It's been quite some time since I did those, so yeah. Another way is obviously if you haven't done it already, do the story mode. It gives you about 5,000 steel, I think, and it gives you a lot of ornaments and stuff. And if you're new to the game, you should do it anyways because you can practice with it and get to know a few characters of the game. Obviously, you should do that. And those are basically all the ways you can get steel. It's not a whole lot you can do, really. But I have a few tips for you on how to keep your steel or how to spend your steel. The first thing I want to talk about, which is quite obvious, is if you have a very low-level character like Shinobi, he's level 1 on me. I never really played him on PC. Never buy those feats. Never buy them. I know this is probably a no-brainer for everyone that has a little bit of experience in this game, but I'm saying this for people that are new to the game, especially now that the standard version was free on Uplay. There are probably a lot of people coming to this game that are new and maybe seeing this video, so don't unlock those, because once you're level 19, you will have unlocked all those and you will have wasted your 4,000 steel. Level 19 is not a lot, it's a few hours of playtime and that's it. So never go for those, never do that, never do anything like that. The next thing, which I have actually seen a lot of people do, well, not wrong, but I have seen a lot of people doing it in a manner that I would never do. You know, what I'm talking about is gear upgrades. For example, what I'm talking about is that if you upgrade something that's, for example, let's go to Warden. For example, if you upgrade like something that's gray, you will very soon replace that thing, and all the steel you've spent, which on these levels is not very high, but let's go for example to Black Prior. And that's not the highest rarity, it's only heroic, but it's still 75 steel to upgrade those things. Which isn't a lot, but if you do a few upgrades, you like the four upgrades that you can do on this, you will have spent at least 300 steel on that, on a thing that you are not going to use for very long. So what I'm saying here is you should only upgrade things that are the highest rarity, which is the turquoise one. Because if you upgrade, for example, something like this, it's a blue one, it's only rare. Like, it doesn't cost super much, but if you do it with all your stuff, you're going to spend a few thousand steel every time you get a new level of gear, and you're going to waste it immensely. I've seen that so many times where people did that. It's not as persistent or it's not as common in the new perk system because normally people don't really see much of a bonus to it, much of a benefit. You know, in the old system, it was much more common to do that. But there are still people that I'm seeing that are doing this, and I highly advocate against it. It doesn't make sense because, yeah, in the short term, it may seem like a good idea, but in a mid-term to long-term, you're going to just waste immense amount of steel. It doesn't make much sense. So that's a very important thing, in my opinion, that a lot of people seem to forget. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Not another tip is if you have gear and you want to upgrade it, but you also want to change the look. Like example, let's take the blade. I want to change this blade. It has the stats that I want, and I want to upgrade it. But I also want to change the look. Change the look first. Change the look first and then upgrade it. Because the higher the level of your gear is, the more steel and material it costs for you to change the look of it. For example, this level 10 takes about 175 steel. If you go to the blade, or let's say to this armor, see, it will cost 300. It's a lot more. So if you want to upgrade and change the look, change the look beforehand and then upgrade. You're going to save a little bit of steel up there. And I know this is very nitpicky. It's very, very little steel you're going to save for this. But if you're doing that for multiple characters, on a long term, you're going to save a lot with this. And those little things, they do add up. So yeah, that's basically how I get all my steel. That's how I did my 60k, spending 60k steel on Black Prior and spending 63k steel on Jomungandr videos. I hope that I could help some of you guys. And if you still have any questions left, just don't hesitate and ask me. I will answer them in a timely manner. And with that, yeah, thank you very much for watching. Like I said, I hope I could help you. Take care of yourselves and goodbye.